Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and it's time to build the Tinkercad house 2020 edition. So let's get cracking. Step one, my friends, is to get to Tinkercad. You can type it into a Google search, or if you're in my classroom, you can use the link that I put in the project. When you get there, I recommend using sign in as Google. If this tutorial pops up because it's your first time, just hit the Tinkercad dashboard to get back, and then we're going to hit create new design. Once Tinkercad launches, click on the red box and then click on what we call the work plane, and it'll drop your first shape into Tinkercad. When you look at your project, we're going to learn how to zoom quick. This is called fit view. When you click it, it zooms all the way in. I wanted you to see that there are white corners or handles, and there are black handles. The black handles are my favorites because they only go in one direction. When you stretch, it shows you the size of the new shape. I'm going to hit the minus to zoom out a little more, and I want you to type the number 70 in that box. Notice it stretches to that exact size. There is a cube up here called the view cube. It's got a front, it's got a top, it's got an edge, and it's got a corner. I want you to click on the corner so you can see the measurement on this side. Click where the 20 was, or whatever number yours is, and I want you to type 50 and press enter. We have just created a cube that is 70 by 50, and I want you to change the height, which it's easier to see from a corner. If you want, you can switch corners just because it's kind of cool. And I want the height to be 30 and press enter. I want our cube to be a different color. When you click the color option, you can pick any color you want. I'm going to make a house out of this, so it's going to be a brown because that's what I'm choosing for my house. Since you're watching a video to learn all this, make sure you pause the video now and complete all those steps accurately. The next thing we're going to do is make this cube so it looks more like walls. To do so, I want you to hit duplicate and then use the arrow keys to nudge your duplicate a little bit away. Change it to what's called a hole with the hole button. And let's move it more by grabbing it and dropping it, and then click its white corners. Instead of 70, we want to take away some, so I'm going to tell you to type 64 and press enter. And I'm going to take the 50, and I want you to type 44 and press enter. And then we want to make it taller, so we're going to type 34 and press enter. We've got two shapes now that are similar, but one is going to be inside the other. Drag a box that touches them both, and you'll notice it says two shapes selected. Then find this button called align. We want the brown one to be the master, so if you click the brown one, this is the middle of the brown, and you can see that is lined up perfect. Then click the corner so you can see this side easily. And you've got three buttons here, and we want the middle one as well. Our hole is exactly in the middle of our cube right now, and when we hit group, those two shapes turn into one sweet building with walls. Alrighty, friends, so now that we got a building, let's add a door. To do so, bring out a box that is called a hole box, and then just click to set it down. We're going to once again make sure we're looking at it from a corner. And we want to click on the white handle, and let's change the width of our door. Instead of 20, make it 10. And then instead of 20 for the height, make it 15 and press enter. Let's take a look at it now from the front edge. So we're just practicing different looks, and there's the front. And you can see our door is pretty nice, but it's not in the middle of our house. Let's practice centering it again by drawing a rectangle that selects them both. Once again, make sure it says two shapes, click the align, and then pick the house, the brown piece, as the master, and there's that center dot that we want to connect it to. If we switch our view cube, so we're looking at from the right edge, you can see that the door cuts all the way through. If we make sure we've got both pieces grabbed and do two shapes and we group, we have just cut out a doorway. Let's go back to this corner, and you can see the sweet little door is right there. Let's go back to the front of our building, and let's add a window. Let's go back to the front of our building, so I'm going to look at it from this corner edge, and set another hole box down. We're going to do a really fancy trick right now. I want you to use your left hand to hold down shift, and then I want you to stretch one of the handles to a crazy number, and then in the box I want you to simply type 10. When you press enter, every measurement goes to size 10 in one step. I'll show you that once again. It's just bring out a cube, set it down, hold the shift key with one hand, and then stretch it out to any number, which can be kind of fun, and then type the other number in the box and it auto snaps to that exact size. So that is a window that is size 10. If you haven't learned it already, here's how you delete the extra window. And let's move to our first window, and we're going to nudge this with our arrow keys to the exact spot we want. I'm going to look at it from that right side to make sure that it pokes through, so you can see it's coming through both sides again. So if we move with the arrow keys, it does left, right, forward, and back on our work plane. This is the work plane right here. If you hold down control and hit the up arrow, it actually moves up your shape. Let's switch to a front view and make sure we like that location. I'm going to do control down and move mine down just a couple clicks. And then once again, I'm going to grab both of those and I'm going to group them. So we have just cut a window. Now right now I'm using my mouse to right click drag so I can look around from all the sides. Let's make one more window together, and then you can make a bunch of windows on your own. Set the cube down, hold down shift, stretch to any number, type the number 10, and then I'm going to use the arrow keys to nudge it left or right where I want. You could try and be perfect, I'm not gonna. And then I'm going to do control up to raise it up, and then I'm going to group those to have both my windows connected, just like that. The next step, friends, is to add a roof. To do the roof, we're going to take this mouse over to the work plane, and once you click it once and then come out over your shape, you will see this little rectangle that you can pick where the next object's gonna land. We wanna drop a roof up here on top of our building. So it gives us this orange work plane. And then find the green roof, and when you click and bring it out, it is able to be set on that spot. Then we can use the black handles to stretch it out so that it'll somewhat fit our building. Now this direction roof is okay, but I want to rotate it the other way. So once again, we're going to find that corner and then look for this handle. Now, when you start rotating with that handle, if you move way away, see how the mouse is away from the shape? It goes 1 degree at a time. If you go close to the shape, so see how the mouse is touching the green? It snaps at these 22.5 degree increments. So that's the easiest way to get the 90 that we wanted. Now we can use the black handles to stretch it so it looks just the way we want. I'm going to give it a little bit of an eave instead of a lot of eave. And then once I've got it lined up close, I'm going to set the work plane back to the ground by clicking once and clicking that blue edge, and then grabbing both items, and let's do that align. So notice it says two shapes. Click on the brown house, click on middle, and then I'm going to look from a corner, and I'm going to pick the other middle. Now if we fit the view and look at it from a corner, which we could use that, you can see we've got a pretty sweet house going on. I'm going to grab these two shapes, and I'm going to use the arrow keys to nudge them back. So I'm just making it so I've got more room to play on my project, and this also gives us room to create a sweet door. Bring out another box, and if you remember right, we made our door whole, 10 wide, and we made it 15 high. We also need to change the thickness of our door, so instead of 20 on this side, I'd like you to make it 3. Now we can use our arrow keys to nudge it close, or, even easier, is to grab those two shapes, click the align button, click the house, and then choose the middle dot, and then choose the front edge dot. It put it in the exact right spot, and we can also now pick a cool color for our door. I'm gonna give mine a dark green. Friends, I need you to click up on the top, and I need you to type the word house where the other words were, and I'm gonna put my initials after it, and then I'm gonna put the 2020 for the year. so we always name our files, and now you need to take a picture of it so you can turn it in. All right, friends, so today has been a lot about getting some basic skills, and it's also about learning how to take your first screenshot and turn it in. So with your shape really cool, I would like you to zoom to the exact spot you think is the best view of your house. If you hold down shift and right click drag, you can change the height of things so you can get a really good angle. When you're happy with your angle, click on send to and take a picture. When you hit this save button, it'll either ask you where to save or it'll just save it on the bottom. I'm gonna choose quick access and I'm gonna choose downloads. And it of course will have your name. Mine's gonna replace it because I already did that once. And then there will be a little bar down here that shows where it is. The coolest way to turn this in, and I'm gonna close that window, is to click this bar and say show in folder. This will let you see the picture you just took. Then you need to return to Google Classroom and you need to find the assignment. Inside you just click add and you're gonna do a file. We need to upload it, and you could search for it in the downloads, but it also has this drag here. So if we go back to our folder, you can just drag that picture to the project. You need to wait patiently for it to become ready, and then you can hit turn in, and then they double check and give you one more chance to hit turn in. And boom, your house project is complete. Alrighty, friends, so now you know how to build a house, now you know how to save a screenshot, and you know how to turn it in. Friends, if you enjoyed the video, please make sure you give it a like. If you got a question, comment, or a suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.